I think this government, the PPM government, has certainly made significant improvements in terms of introducing transparency in a real way to central government. We've had regular weekly press briefings. We've passed the Freedom of Information Law. And I think the opportunity is right now for us to move that even further, where we do things like taking the public the meetings of statutory authorities and making some of those public so that the members of the public can come in and listen if they wish to do so. And like any other legislation, I think there'll be opportunity for us to strengthen the provisions of the Freedom of Information Law as we move forward and begin to implement that. But we've made significant improvements in terms of the legislative framework for businesses to operate in Cayman. And I think there's an opportunity to further enhance that to ensure that the cost of doing business, as an example, is reduced. And the whole legislative framework with respect to establishing businesses is less cumbersome and less costly. So that is something that we certainly recognize and that we will be making improvements to. I also think that the opportunities are right for us to begin to put more incentives in place to enhance the packages that we have in place now for Caymanians to own businesses and to operate businesses and to allow them to compete more effectively through our enhanced education policies, providing the educational opportunities for them to gain experience and also to own their own businesses in Cayman through those incentive packages. But I think we need to continue to position our product, our tourism product, as an upscale product. We have made significant improvements in that area with the Pride program, which is our customer service program. We've significantly improved our customer standards. We've trained a large number of employees, and that program continues. We also have our tourism apprenticeship training program that's in place, and that's on the technical and vocational side. So those are significant and important improvements that we will continue to enhance. On the physical side, I think we need to ensure that we have our cruise berthing facilities in place as quickly as possible, and that program is in the works, as you know. The airport also needs to be redeveloped, and that is underway. So those are all physical improvements that are very, very important to positioning our tourism product in such a way that we can consistently deliver what we say we have in Cayman, which is an upscale tourism product. I think the two biggest challenges, first of all, I would start with the global economic crisis. This government has a very, very strong partnership with our private sector, both in terms of the tourism industry and the financial services industry, our two main pillars of the economy. And so we need to continue to maintain that relationship. And, you know, we've done negotiations around the world with various countries and with various oversight bodies, and it's important that there is continuity in those areas. And we have proven that we have the team with the experience and the know-how to achieve all of that. And so now, as the world faces these global economic challenges and as they trickle down to the Cayman Islands, it is important that we maintain that team and that we don't change at this point to the unknown and the unproven and the inexperienced candidates that are out there.